this nation can be great again. What makes a strong and great nation? An enlightened, united, and empowered people. Because a good leader is produced and chosen by righteous and enlightened people. So that, if we want our country to reclaim the glory and greatness, the Maharlika country, the original paradise on earth, Gold Moon or Lemuria, we must seek and enthrone the anointed leader of the land, because it is this leader who is vested with authority to implement God's will and divine plan on the tiny island in the Far East, ang bayang pinagpala ang bansang Maharlika. This country, from the rising of the sun, shall rise again and will stand as the greatest nation among all nations in the world. But God is a God of hope and justice, as He will, the greatest Maharlika nation shall rise again, only with the right man who holds the key and the calling. Our leader, whom we will nominate today, once emerged victorious, does not only have the legal and moral mandate, he has the spiritual and divine mandate. And what is this divine mandate? Many spiritual seers and masters declared ang bayang Pilipinas na siyang bayang Maharlika, siyang bayang pinagpala. Ang mga Pilipino ay mga lahing pili at pinino, endowed with the birthright. Ito na ang matanggal nang hinihintay. Yes, the time has come to witness the fulfillment of the prophecy. Ang Pangulo na siyang iginohit ng tadhana. He and his family had experienced extremes. Once he is the son of the most powerful, respected, and great leader. Yet he and his family was misjudged, humiliated in the eyes of the world, and suffered the worst, that even their liberty was denied. The Holy Book says, there's a time and season for everything. There's a time to cry, but there's a time to laugh. There's a time to mourn, but there's a time to be happy. There's a time of injustice, but there's a time for the truth. There's a time of suffering, but there's a time to rejoice. Now is the time to rejoice, to claim justice, time for vindication, and most of all, the time for the victory and comeback. At mapalad tayong lahat, we are not only a witness, but an active medium to take part sa pagbabalik ng Hagila sa Malacañang. Our national hero, Dr. Jose Rizal, says, a strong and great nation is not a gift from God. It is an attainment of the people. It is a thing that we must have to work for it, fight for it, and if necessary, die for it. Today, the KBL party, founded 43 years ago, we produce the greatest president. Today, we will again converge, regather, and renew our commitment and vow to work and fight for the victory of the next and most awaited president of the Republic of the Philippines, the Maharlika Nation, His Excellency Ferdinand Romualdez Bongbong Marcos Jr. My countrymen, matagal na po kayo naghihirap. Today, I will ask you, are you willing to work and fight for the victory of PBM? Are you willing to work and fight for the victory of the next president of the Republic of the Philippines? Mabuhay ang KDL! Mabuhay si Bongbong Marcos! As we declare today, the next president of the Republic of the Philippines.
resolution of the KBL, Kilusang Bagong Lipunan Party, the National Assembly nominations and endorsing the candidacy of Honorable Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. as the party's presidential candidate this coming May 9, 2022 national election. Resolution number 1, series of 2021. Whereas the KBL, Kilusang Bagong Lipunan, a registered political party recognized by the COMELEC, is nominating its own candidates to participate in the May 9, 2022 national and local election. Whereas the KBL party, in compliance to the COMELEC guidelines in the selection of nomination of the candidates, the national official and members of the KBL party conducted the party's national convention at Thunderbird Resort, Binangonan, Rizal, on September 24, 2021, for the purpose of selecting and nominating its candidate for president and other national candidates. Whereas, during the conduct of National Assembly, former Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos was nominated as the party's official candidate for the president, and this was unanimously approved by all the officers and members of the KBL. Now, on the motion of Honorable Efren A. Rapanan Sr., the party president, unanimously seconded, resolved, as it is hereby resolved, to approve the nomination and endorsement to the candidacy of former Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. as the party's official candidate for the position of president in the national and local election on May 9, 2022. Resolve further to convey to Honorable Bongbong Marcos Jr. the resolution of endorsement and nomination for his acceptance and consideration. Resolve furthermore to nominate Attorney Larry Gadon as one of the senatorial candidates in the KBL lineup. Approved September 24, 2022, Thunderbird Resort, Binangonan, Rizal, Philippines. I move for the approval of the resolution, Mr. Chairman.
There's a resolution endorsing and nominating Honorable Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. as the party's candidate for president and Attorney Larry Gadon as senator of the party. To those in favor, say aye. To those object, say no. Inasmuch as there is no objection, the resolution endorsing Honorable Bongbong marked as the party's candidate in May 22 election is hereby approved. Same resolution is hereby approved for Senator Larry Gadon as the senator candidate of KBL. Ladies and gentlemen, party mates, may I request everybody to listen to the message of the Honorable Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.
And my greetings to all the members and the leadership of the Kilusang Bagong Lipunan Party. Of course, we all know that the KBL has been the stalwart party that my father formed in his time in office. And the KBL has had a very clear set of ideologies and aspirations for our country. The vision of our country was very, very clear as it came from my father. And this is what the KBL continues to strive for and continues to work for and continues to exist for, so that we are at least representatives of that vision of my father. And I thank all of you who have been with us all of these years and that have never left the fold of the Kilusang Bagong Lipunan. Thank you for all that. I am of course overwhelmed by the expressions of support and endorsement that you have given me today. I hope it is because I have stayed true to the ideals of KBL that has been handed down from my father's time. I hope to continue to work to achieve that ideal, to achieve that dream, to achieve that vision for our country. The KBL has endured through such hard times, and yet we continue to see the work that KBL has done and the political involvement that KBL continues to have at a very high level. And so I congratulate all of you who have kept the faith and who have kept the fires burning and have reminded our people that these aspirations, these ideals, this vision we have for our country is important. Thank you very much.
The KBL has remained to be a very active political party, and as a matter of fact, up to now, the KBL is considered or recognized as one of the 6 dominant parties, and that we are very much honored to be the party that will carry Bongbong Marcos to the presidency. And I'd like to thank also the KBL for nominating me as a candidate for senator. Sa totoo lang, BBM now is the strongest candidate. This is a fact. And that this is the reason why the Aquinos and the Yellows are doing everything to discredit Bongbong Marcos with rehashed issues on martial law and the alleged stolen wealth. But they haven't realized that the Aquino appointed, the Aquino controlled Sandigan Bayan has dismissed all the ill-gotten cases against the Marcoses. Walang kahit isa lumusot, despite the fact that the Sandigan Bayan justices were appointed by the Aquinos, despite the fact that the Sandigan is controlled by the Aquinos, that dismissed lahat ng kaso. This only means that lahat ng sinasabi nilang mga kasinungalingan kay Presidente Marcos at sa pamilya nito ay pawang mga basura. Lahat yan ay propaganda at lahat yan ay kasinungalingan. Kaya ngayon, a lot of the majority now of the Filipinos have realized that all of these are propaganda, all of these are brainwashing, all of these are indoctrination of the Aquinos and the Yellows. In fact, they have resuscitated their propaganda against the Marcoses by this Ateneo and Martial Law Museum. Nakakatawa ito sapagkat the one who is operating this so-called Ateneo Martial Law Museum is someone who has not even born during the time of martial law. I am very much sure that this fellow is a communist and a scholar of National Democratic Front. The only reason why this martial law rehashed chart issues are being resuscitated is because the NDF, the Aquinos, and the Yellows are very afraid. They are now shivering that Marcos, Bongbong Marcos, is the strongest candidate. In a survey in Central Luzon done by congressmen, Bongbong landed with 27% survey score. And the next is 20%. And the next is 18% and 11%. And I will not mention the names. In an internal survey in Angeles City, Bongbong got 28%. And the second is 18% with a 10% margin. And even in the survey conducted by the Liberal Party, Bongbong came out number one. Oh, kaya takot na takot sila sapagkat ang mangyayari dyan, kapag ka sila ay pagka nakaupo na si Bongbong Marcos, lahat ng kasinungalingan nila, all their narratives about the martial law, about the ill-gotten cases, about the human rights violations, all of this will be refuted and all of this will be proven to be lies, propaganda, and indoctrination. You might wonder why the NDF and the Communist Party is still rehashing these issues. Ganito kasi yan. Ang mga NDF, sila ang nakikinabang sa bilyong pera na nakakalap ng NPA. Because the NPAs are extorting money from businessmen, from big corporations. And the ones that are benefiting from this are the members of NDF. Ito yung mga taong to, hindi sila yung nasa bundok. Hindi sila yung mga nandyan sa pakikipaglaban. Sila, ito yung mga komunistang professor sa UP, mga komunistang pare, at mga komunista na mga editor ng mga dyaryo. All of these people are benefiting from this continuous barrage against the Marcoses because they have to keep the revolution alive by keeping these NPAs so that they can continuously export money from the businessmen and big corporations. Yan lang ang dahilan kung bakit sila, kung bakit nila laging pinapaulit-ulit itong issue dito sa martial law, itong issue sa mga Marcoses. Kasi pinagkakakitaan nila. You would wonder why some of the professors in UP who only teaches two or three subjects, how do they survive? Because they are getting money, because they are getting paid by the National Democratic Front. Also the same with this NUPL. Most of these lawyers are no client, no case lawyers na nagpupunta lang dyan sa NUPL kasi palagi silang may sweldo galing sa NDF. And the same also with the flag lawyers. Some of them are really true to their calling that they want to defend the oppressed. But most of them are communist paid. They are getting money from the communists. And this is the reason why until now they are rehashing these issues of martial law, these human rights violations. Pero ang hindi nila binabanggit, yung mga human rights violations of the Aquinos, no? What happened to the 7 union presidents of Hacienda Lucita? Lahat panatay. Oh. What happened to the Mincholo Massacre? Ilan ang napatay doon? Ilan ang nasaktan doon? Hindi nila binabanggit yon. And of course, the more than 5,000 NPA cadres who were executed by JOMA because they want to surrender. No? Nabuhay lamang ang NPAs na yan at yung mga martial law issues na yan dahil kasi they are so afraid na lahat ng kasinungalingan nila, lahat ng pag-i-indoctrinate nila, lahat ng pambibrainwash nila sa mga taong bayan ay mapapatunayan na lahat yan ay kasinungalingan. In fact, if you will read the social media now, even the post of Bam Aquino, which I spell as B-U-M, even the post of Bam Aquino, lahat inutuligsa, lahat kinukontra siya na sinasabi na mas maganda pa ang buhay natin noong martial law. And these people who are, itong merong isang nag-TikTok na isang mataba na pangit na babae na ang sinasabi niya ay yung marami raw inutang during the time of Marcos dahil daw doon sa mga infrastruktura. What would life be? Can I ask you now? What would life be kung walang South Luzon Expressway? Kung walang North Luzon Expressway? Kung walang mga proyekto na kagaya ng Heart Center na RITM, Lung Center, kung ano pa, National Kidney Institute, na lahat ay naging sagot sa kasagot sa problema ng pandemic. Kung wala yung mga yan, ano buhay natin ngayon? Kung pupunta ka ng Baguio, maglalakad ka? Pupunta ka ng Batangas, maglalakad ka? Ganun ba? Yun kasi ang isip ng mga Aquino. No? If you will notice, lahat ng proyekto ni Marcos noon ay isinantabi. Hindi itinuloy. And that is the reason why we are so lagging behind compared to other Asian countries. Unang-unang nagkaroon ng Pilipinas ng light rail transit, yung LRT1. At natapos yun noong 1992. At dapat ang lahat ng mga 7 routes of LRT ay dapat ay by 1995 or 1996 ay natapos na. Ano ang naging sanhi niyan? Katakot-takot na traffic. Because Cory Aquino scrapped all the LRT projects, anong nangyari? Lahat ng tao over the years nagbilihan ng kotse. Eh wala namang bagong kalsada. So ang nangyari, nagka-traffic-traffic. Kasalanan yan ng Aquino administration. Ang Bataan Nuclear Power Plant, kung naituloy yun, 600 megawatts of very cheap source of energy. Kung natuloy yun, di sana hindi nagka-brownout. Sana hindi umalis, hindi nagsipagsara ang mga factories dito, yung mga multinational companies, hindi sana nagsipagsara dito sa Pilipinas. Milyon-milyong Pilipino ang nawalan ng trabaho dahil sa mga pulisiya ng mga dilawan, lalo na ni Cory at ni Noynoy Aquino at ni FDR. Ang nangyari dito, naging backward ang pag-unlad ng Pilipinas. Sa halip na tayo ay sumulong, papataas, tayo ay naging backward dahil sa mga Aquinos. Kaya ngayon, takot na takot sila na manalo si Bongbong Marcos, sapagkat ang pagkapanalo ni Bongbong Marcos ay isang katotohanan na lahat ng mga sinabi ng indoctrination, propaganda at kasinungalingan ng mga Aquino ay mabubunyag. No? Ako ay nagpapasalamat sa pag-nominate sa akin ng KBL. Isang malaking-malaking karangalan ito para sa akin. At ako ay nangangako na kung ako ay maihalal na senador, ang isa sa unang-una kong gagawin ay magpo-propose ako ng constitutional amendment na ang termino dapat ng senador, isa lang. Hindi yung kagaya ni Drilon, 24 years na nasa Senado, nilumot. Ginawang negosyo, ginawang hanap buhay ang pagiging senador. No? Marami dyan, 18 years, 16 years. Kung talagang ikaw matalino ka, kung lalo pa kung abogado na kagaya ni Drilon, kagaya ni Pangilinan, no? Kung talagang matalino kayo, sa loob ng 6 na taon, marami kayong legislation na magagawa na makabuluhan. Naka 24 years ka, nandiyan ka pa rin. Araw na itulong nyo sa bayan. Wala. At papalitan dapat ang constitution ay magkaroon ng direct foreign investment. Yung 1987 constitution ni Cory Aquino, it was just a protection of the oligarchs. Protection ng oligarchs lang yan. Dapat kung nagkaroon tayo ng foreign direct investment, dapat ay mas maunlad tayo. Look at Hong Kong. Look at Singapore. Do they mind that foreign investors are on their lands? Hindi. And actually, ang laki ng agwat nila sa atin. Kasi they allow foreign investment. And dapat, ang isa pang pagbabago sa constitution that I will propose is the one slate of president and vice president. Dapat ang president at vice president, isang ticket lang. The vote for the president should be a vote also for the vice president. Para hindi kagaya ng nangyayari dito. Ang vice president ay bangayan ng bangayan at wala na ginawa kundi siraan yung ginagawa ng administrasyon. Kasi gusto magpapita. And another legislation that I will propose is the lowering of the electricity or energy. Paano natin pwedeng gawin yan? Sa ngayon, tututulan talaga yan ng mga oligarko. Pero there is a formula for this that everybody will be happy. The citizen will enjoy a lower rate of electricity and at the same time, the oligarchs will be happy with the return of investment by putting a cap and putting a limit on the revenues that they can get, on the profit that they can get. Ang ayaw lang naman nila, yung total ay tanggalin mo. Pero kung yan, ay bibigyan mo ng magandang compromise yan, we can do it. Eh sa ngayon, ang nangyayari, the Filipinos are the modern slaves. We are the modern slaves for working hard only to pay for the basic utilities like electricity, water, tollgate, gasoline. Lahat yan nagmahal, kagagawan ng mga dilaw. Kaya yung pagbabalik sa Malacanang ng isang Marcos ay isang signalis na magkakaroon uli tayo ng magandang buhay. Mabuhay si Bongbong Marcos! Mabuhay ang KBL!